This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Apple Computer, Inc. v. Microsoft Corporation, 35F3D 1435 9th, Circle 1994 was a copyright infringement lawsuit in which Apple Computer, Inc. now Apple Inc. sought to prevent Microsoft and Hewlett-Packard from using visual graphical user interface GUI elements that were similar to those in Apple's Lisa and Macintosh operating systems. The court ruled that Apple cannot get patent-like protection for the idea of a graphical user interface, or the idea of a desktop metaphor. In the midst of the Apple v. Microsoft lawsuit, Xerox also sued Apple alleging that Mac's GUI was heavily based on Xerox's. The district court dismissed Xerox's claims without addressing whether Apple's GUI infringed Xerox's. Apple lost all claims in the Microsoft suit except for the ruling that the trash can icon and folder icons from Hewlett-Packard's NewWave Windows application were infringing. The lawsuit was filed in 1988 and lasted 4 years. The decision was affirmed on appeal in 1994, and Apple's appeal to the U.S. Supreme Court was denied. Contents 1 Background 2 Court Case 3 Impact 4 See also 5 References 6 External links. Background: Apple had agreed to license certain parts of its GUI to Microsoft for use in Windows 10, but when Microsoft made changes in Windows 20 adding overlapping windows and other features found in the Macintosh GUI, Apple filed suit. Apple added additional claims to the suit when Microsoft released Windows 30. Apple claimed the look and feel of the Macintosh operating system, taken as a whole, was protected by copyright, and that each individual element of the interface, such as the existence of windows on the screen, the rectangular appearance of windows, windows could be resized, overlap, and have title bars, was not as important as all these elements taken together. After oral arguments, the court insisted on an analysis of specific GUI elements that Apple claimed were infringements. Apple listed 189 GUI elements. The court decided that 179 of these elements had been licensed to Microsoft in the Windows 10 agreement, and most of the remaining 10 elements were not copyrightable. Either they were unoriginal to Apple, or they were the only possible way of expressing a particular idea. Midway through the suit, Xerox filed a lawsuit against Apple claiming Apple had infringed copyrights Xerox held on its GUIs. Xerox had invited the Macintosh design team to view their GUI computers at the Park Research Lab. These visits had been very influential on the development of the Macintosh GUI. Xerox's lawsuit appeared to be a defensive move to ensure that if Apple v. Microsoft established that look and feel was copyrightable, then Xerox would be the primary beneficiary, rather than Apple. The Xerox case was dismissed for a variety of legal reasons. Court case: the district court ruled that it would require a standard of virtual identity between Windows and the Macintosh at trial in order for Apple to prove copyright infringement. Apple believed this to be too narrow of a standard and that a more broad look and feel was all that should be necessary at trial. As a result, both parties agreed that a jury trial was unnecessary given the rulings, and Apple filed an appeal to the Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals in order to have the district court's characterization overruled. After the district court ruled in favor of Microsoft, Apple appealed the decision, arguing that the district court only considered infringements on the individual elements of Apple's GUI, rather than the interface as a whole. The appeals court almost entirely affirmed the ruling of the district court, establishing that almost all the similarities spring either from the license or from basic ideas, and their obvious expression. Illicit copying could occur only if the works as a whole are virtually identical. However, the circuit court did reverse the district court's decision not to award attorney's fees to Microsoft, clarifying and sending the case back to the district court to resolve the issue, citing Brown Bag Software v. Symantec Corp. The circuit court dissected the GUI in order to separate expression from ideas, as expression, but not ideas, are covered by copyright law. The court outlined 5 ideas that it identified as basic to a GUI: desktop, windows, icon images of office items, manipulations of icons, menus, and the opening and closing of objects. The court established that Apple could not make copyright claims based on these ideas and could only make claims on the precise expression of them. The court also pointed out that many of Apple's claims fail on an originality basis. Apple admittedly licensed many of its representations from Xerox, and copyright protection only extends to original expression. Apple returned to its complete look and feel argument, stating that while the individual components were not original, the complete GUI was. The court rejected these arguments because the parts were not original. Impact: much of the court's ruling was based on the original licensing agreement between Apple and Microsoft, draft for Windows 10, and this fact made the case more of a contractual matter than of copyright law. To the chagrin of Apple, this also meant that the court avoided a more far-reaching look and feel copyright precedent ruling. However, the case did establish that the analytic dissection rather than the general look and feel of a user interface is vital to any copyright decision on such matters. In 1997, 3 years after the lawsuit was decided, all lingering infringement questions against Microsoft regarding the Lisa and Macintosh GUI, as well as Apple's QuickTime piracy lawsuit against Microsoft, were settled in direct negotiations. Apple agreed to make Internet Explorer their default browser, to the detriment of Netscape. Microsoft agreed to continue developing Microsoft Office and other software for the Mac over the next 5 years. Microsoft also purchased $150 million of non-voting Apple stock. Both parties entered into a patent cross-licensing agreement. See also Apple Inc. litigation. Microsoft litigation. Pirates of Silicon Valley. References. Carrot. Microsoft vs. Apple, The History of Computing. Infographic, archived from the original on the 12th of June 2013, retrieved the 18th of April 2013. Macintosh Copyright, The New York Times, December 15, 1989. Carrot. Xerox Corp. v. Apple Computer, Inc., 734 F. Supp. 1542, Cal. 1990. Carrot. Pirates of Silicon Valley, Fun Facts and Information. FunTriviacom. Retrieved 18 April 2014. External links. Text of Apple Computer, Inc. v. Microsoft Corp. is available from Tim Cook, CEO, Albert Gore Jr., Robert A. Iger, Andrea Ewing, Arthur D. Levinson, Chairman, Ronald D. Sugar, Susan L. Wagner, former Fred D. Anderson, Gil Emilio, Bill Campbell, Mickey Drexler, Larry Ellison, Steve Jobs, Delano Lewis, Mike Markula, Arthur Rock, Eric Schmidt, John Scully, Edgar S. Woolard Jr., Jerry York. Executives. Current. Tim Cook, CEO, Jonathan Ive, CDO, Jeff Williams, COO, Luca Maestri, CFO, Angela Arendts, Philip W. Schiller, Eddie Q. Craig Federighi, Dan Riccio, Joni Shruji, Bruce Sewell, Lisa Jackson, Paul Deniv, former Steve Jobs, Fred D. Anderson, John Browett, Tony Fidel, Scott Forstall, Nancy R. Heinen, Ron Johnson, Peter Oppenheimer, Mark Papermaster, John Rubenstein, Bertrand Serlet, Sina Tamadin, A.V. Tevanian, Gil Emilio, Ellen Hancock, David Nagel, Guarino DeLuca. Services. Apple ID, Apple Maps, Apple Music, Apple Pay, Developer IAD, Test Flight, Game Center, iCloud, iWork, News, Newsstand, Stores, Apple Store, Online App Store, iBook Store, iTunes Store, Mac App Store. Support. AppleCare, Apple Specialist Certifications, Genius Bar, ProCare, 1-to-1 Products, Hardware, Macintosh, Intel Transition, iPod Nano, Shuffle Touch, iPhone, iPad Mini, Air Pro, Apple TV, Apple Watch, Apple SIM, Apple Mobile Processors, Software, Classic, Mac OS, Mac OS History, Server Software, iOS Version History, TV OS, WatchOS, Core Foundation, Developer Tools, Final Cut, Studio Logic, Studio, QuickTime, CarPlay Companies, Subsidiaries, Beats Electronics, Beats Music, Braeburn Capital, FileMaker Inc. Acquisitions, Anabit, Authentec Inc., Beats Electronics, Beats Music, Q Imagic, Fingerworks, Intrinsity, Lala, Next, Nothing Real, Mateo, PA, Semi, PrimeSense, Siri, SpotSetter, Topsy, Related Advertising, 1984, Think Different, Get a Mac, iPods, Product, Red, Campus, Design, IDG, Topography, DD, Chuxing, History, Codenames, Community, Criticism, Litigation, FBI, Apple, Encryption, Dispute, iOS, App Approvals, Apple Music Festival, Welcome to Macintosh, 2008, Documentary, Artistic Depictions of Steve Jobs, Book Portal, VE, Microsoft History, All Topics, People, List, Founders, Bill Gates, Paul Allen, Board of Directors, John W. Thompson, Chairman, Satya Nadella, CEO, Dina Dublin, Maria Clave, David Marquardt, Charles Noska, Helmut, Panka, Mason, Morfitt, John W. Stanton, Senior Leadership Team, Satya Nadella, CEO, Scott Guthrie, Amy Hood, CFO, Chi Lu, Terry Meyerson, Harry Shum, Kevin Turner, COO, Corporate VPs, Joe Belfiore, Richard Rashid, SVPs, Somasegar, SVP, Divisions, Engineering Groups, Mobile, Skype Unit, Digital Crimes Unit, Garage Press, Research Studios, Net Foundation, Outerker Foundation, Estates, Microsoft Redmond Campus, Microsoft Tallow, Microsoft Algeria, Microsoft Egypt, Microsoft India, Microsoft Japan, Product Families, Operating Systems, Windows Software, Office Servers, Visual Studio Hardware, HoloLens, Lumia, Surface, Xbox, Web Properties, Bing, Channel 9, Codeplex, Developer Network, MSN, OfficeCom, OneDrive, Outlook.com, TechNet Windows Store Conferences Build Mix PDC Techt WinHack WPC Criticism Bundling of Microsoft Windows Clippy ILU Internet Explorer Microsoft Bob underscore NSAKEY Windows 2000. Mi XP Vista Xbox 360 Litigation Alcatel-Lucent v. Microsoft Apple v. Microsoft European Union Microsoft Competition Case Microsoft v. Lindos Microsoft vs. Microsoft Microsoft v. Shaw United States v. Microsoft Acquisitions 6 Wunderkinder Altamira Software Aquantive Azixi The Blue Ribbon Soundworks Bungie Callista Technologies Colloquy Connectix Consumers Software Danger Faircast FASA Studio Fast Search Lionhead Studios Massive Incorporated Mobile Data Labs Mojang Nokia Devices and Services Onfolio Pondo Networks Perceptive Pixel Placeware PowerSet ProClarity Rare Revolution Analytics ScreenTonic Secure Islands Skype Sunrise Atelier SwiftKey Winternals Software Telio Telekinesis Research Telme Networks Twisted Pixel Games Vermeer Technologies Visio Corporation Vividi Defunct Volumetrics VX Stream WEBTV Networks Xamarin Yammer UP Category Commons Microsoft Portal Wiki Project